Hello everyone, this is Haji Dalwal. Welcome to Tackling Tech. We are at Microsoft Ignite in Chicago. Microsoft has made a lot of announcements for amazing products and solutions and features, and it's unbelievable. One of the items we want to talk about today is a hot item. Joining me is my friend and colleague, Surabhi. Welcome.
Hey, Arji. Thank you for having me here. Hello, everyone. My name is Surabhi, and I'm a product manager with Hotpatch.
Great. And you're based in Seattle. We've known each other for quite some time. Right? Worked in different capacities and stuff like that. So the big hot item that was announced by our very own Satya Nadella is hotpatching for clients. Let's talk about that. What is hotpatching?
So hotpatching is a concept that has been out there for servers for the last 2 years. Mm-hmm. We've introduced hotpatching now to our client devices. Hotpatching is basically your monthly beta releases with security updates for client. And these updates do not require a reboot.
Reboot, that's the magic word, right? So that's one of the pain points that, you know, anyone that has been working with Windows, whether it's an end user or things like that, it's always like, oh my God, I got to reboot. But we got to keep them secure, right? So this is going to eliminate a lot of those pain points.
Absolutely. And when you talk about security, that's absolutely top of mind for Microsoft right now. We want to make sure that we are doing all the right things for you to have your devices secured as quickly as possible. So with hotpatching, you can actually get to a faster compliance rate using our monthly security B releases through hotpatching.
Okay, that's fantastic. Do they ever have to reboot?
Yes. So there is a schedule for hot patching. We have 4 baseline releases, once for every quarter, followed by 2 hot patch releases where you do not need to reboot the machines.
Okay.
The reason for having those 4 baseline months is because we really want your devices to have that optimum performance and operational excellence as well. So once in a quarter, it's advisable that you reboot, get your devices up to the baseline, and then leverage the hot patching months for the next 2 months.
Fantastic. So what are the quarters? What are those timelines?
So our typical calendar for hot patching is your January, April, July, and October months are your baseline months. And then between those are your 2 consecutive hot patch months. In an occasion where, because of a specific security vulnerability fix, we might need to create another additional ad hoc baseline, then that would be created and we will upload that onto the Microsoft release health page for information.
I see. So there are 2 that we could use to some real critical patches.
Absolutely.
That need to get out there and reboot. Okay, great. So instead of rebooting 12 times a year, now we're bringing it down to 4 times a year. That's amazing. That's fantastic.
Yes, that's potentially a lot of benefit for our end users.
Yes.
And organizations that have business critical machinery, ATMs, medical equipments, where rebooting is a big hassle.
True. Yeah, like research facilities that have to run, you know, long research, projects and stuff like that.
Absolutely.
And you can't just reboot. Absolutely. So how does this work under the hood?
So it's very simple. It's just a 1 button click. So all our customers who are using Hotpatch and leveraging update management using Hotpatch, they just need to go ahead and create a newly added profile policy, which is called your Windows Quality Update. It's in public preview now. And just add all your security groups and your Microsoft Entra ID device groups into that specific policy.
Okay.
There's this very simple toggle in there that says, whenever your device is eligible and the update is applicable to your device, Microsoft will go ahead and offer you a hot patch. But in occasions where there's no hot patch payload available or your device is not eligible, we would still keep you secured using the traditional latest cumulative update.
You mentioned eligible a couple of times. So that's an important thing that we should bring up. What is eligible means?
So in order for hot patches to actively function on your devices need to be on a specific OS version. So hot patch today is applicable to Windows 11 24 H2 devices. So that's one of the eligibility criteria. You also need to ensure that VBS is enabled on your devices. That's a key component for hot patching payloads to work.
Right. So VBS, Windows 11 version 24H2, you also need Intune, right? And of course, the licenses that Absolutely. Go along with it, right? Yes. That's pretty good. So as far as the end users concerned, they don't see anything different, right?
That's so true. This is an absolutely seamless process for end users. Mm-hmm. If they are willing to go and go onto the Windows Update setting page, they can see this beautiful little green bar that shows them, congratulations, we've updated your device without having you to restart the device.
Oh, that's
so that's nice. An indication for the end users. But for them, the experience is absolutely seamless.
Okay. And then for the IT admins, the reboots that happen quarterly, is that something that they can control? Do they have any form of control there, whether it's the ring based or not?
So that's a very interesting question, Harjeet. And we've basically honored all the settings that the IT admin has in place using their update ring policies. So we honored the timing of when to install the hot patch when it's applicable based on the update rings, and they work together in conjunction. The only change when you assign your devices to the hot patch policy is let your update rings decide when to give you the update, but we'll give you a hot patch update whenever it's applicable to the device. So you don't need to change any of those settings. They can still be in place.
Okay. So it's very important to make this clear. This is only for Windows 11, 24H2, not 23H2, not 22H2, and also not applicable for Windows 10.
Correct.
So all your traditional patching mechanisms will work for those other devices.
Absolutely.
As a former IT admin myself, and also now, you know, dealing with a lot of IT admins and MVPs and things like that, one of the things that they always ask with any solution that we put out there is reporting.
Right.
They want to know how the environment is doing. Is it working? Is it not working? Right? How to troubleshoot? Is there reporting capability with hot patching?
Absolutely, Harjeet. So we've done a couple of things here. With your existing compliance reporting that you have within Hotpatch, we've made sure that whether you're taking a hot patch update or you're taking your traditional LCU update, the compliance definition is met whether you take either or. So that is one change that's there. So your compliance definition will be absolutely accurately given to you at any point in time. In addition to that, we have another report, which is specifically for hot patching, which shows you how many devices did you actually enroll into hot patching? Mm-hmm. What's the status of those devices? Have they taken hot patch, or because of any eligibility criteria missing from those devices, have they taken the traditional LCU? And that and the configurations as well for the devices of what eligibility criteria is not meeting has been clearly specified in those reports. So at any point in time, as soon as they create the policy, they can go and take a view at this report, which will help them track the progress of hot patching policy.
Okay, so it will tell them in detail if a computer is not eligible and why.
Correct.
For example, VBS is not enabled and things like that.
Yes. Okay. Yes.
All right, so we made this announcement here at Microsoft Ignite, and we said, hey, it's available. Is it really available now?
Yes, so hot patching is now available under public preview for all our customers who would want to use it.
So all they have to do is go into Intune, flip the button, and
Absolutely.
They're good to go.
Absolutely, just create a hot patch policy, and it'll just flow seamlessly.
Fantastic. And they should see that feature in their Intune portal right now.
Yes. So under your devices, Windows Update, where you control your entire update management for all content types, you'll see it under quality updates.
Okay. Fantastic. So finally, to close off, we want to hear from our customers. We want feedback, right?
Correct. Absolutely. That's vital for us.
Yeah. How can they do that?
They could actually reach out to aka.ms/intunefeedback.
That's right. And I believe they can do that as well if they are already a member of the CCP program, Customer Connection Program. And if they're not, they can join because we share a lot of information there as well, right? Roadmaps and things like that.
Correct. So. And once you're in the CCP program as well, they can join us for any other private previews in the future regarding hot patching or any other new features. So that's a very good spot to be in.
Thank you so much for being on the show. It's such a pleasure. I learned something new as well, and I'm sure everybody else did as well.
Thanks, Harjeet, for having me here. It was a pleasure.
Yeah, we'll see you again. Thank you for joining Tackling Tech. I hope you enjoyed this episode and learned something new. For future episodes, please like and subscribe. See you next time.